tree?
That one oak tree right there?
Uh-huh.
That's where it's at. It's right in the backside there.
Okay, well, it hasn't been moved yet.
So it hasn't been moved?
I don't think so.
Oh.
If it has, it hasn't been moved very far.
Just, yeah. You can't get Millie up there.
Oh, I can't get up there. Yeah. Okay. No way.
Well,
You guys, and I'll watch you.
Okay.
Well, you better get in out of the sun then.
Yeah. I'll get in out of the sun over here.
Do you want me to bring a chair? I can follow you in a chair in case you need to sit down halfway up.
No?
Okay. You're a whippersnapper?
Yeah.
Whippersnapper.
I'll just roll down if I can.
You don't think you can... We can't help you maneuver through...
I doubt
around
it.
...around those rocks in there?
Yeah.
Because the easiest way is over the rocks.
Yeah, boy, I used to be up there all the time. Every Sunday, there'd be hundreds of people up there walking around.
That post went, or there was a fence that went across it?
There was, well, there used to be a little white picket fence, a little small picket fence that went around that.
You just grab. Don't touch that.
Obviously, the fire came through here, right?
Yeah.
So when we came up here and we found it, you notice this, it's got some white paint on it, so obviously somebody put this here.
Yeah.
So more than likely it's a fence. So if you come up this way, watch your step in this these oak branches here.
Mm-hmm. One step up and two down.
Hey, let me help her up, Pam. Give me a hand. Come on up, Marguerite. Come from here. This is the headstone.
Oh.
So, I'm thinking it's laying across this way like that.
Yeah.
Right?
You know, that's about right, because it's right under. Later on, it was right in that tank. It's full over there, too.
And you see how it's a flat spot right here? And it was dug away. You can kind of see right over there how the dirt was dug away a little bit. Flatten it out. And a little ways from there, this oak tree there was probably not there. So it would have been a nice little vista from right here, which was probably the idea why they put it here. You think, Marguerite? Does that make sense?
Uh-huh. And you said they had moved it about 15 feet.
Well, what Millie said was that when they built the dam, that they moved it. Otherwise, it had been underneath the dam.
Yeah.
So, and when you described it to me, you said it was about 15 feet from the dam.
Yeah, well, from the base of it.
From the base of the dam. So, the edge of the dam is right there, and, you know, as the crow flies, it's about 15 feet from the base of the dam.
Well, you were really diligent about locating something.
Yeah.
We don't mess around. Now, when we get something in our head, something like this especially, you know, with, 1870s.
There's no marking or anything like that.
No. We scraped away here. I'll show you. When we came up here, there was a... The deer had been laying right here. Mm-hmm. You can see these rocks right here are not from this general area. This rock was brought up from the rocks that they were using over there. So I'm thinking, since the face of that rock is pointing this way, the body was probably laid in this direction with the head over there, more than likely.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
It does. You know, it really does.
Because this is the flat area that would have used it right in the middle.
Yeah. Yeah, I wish Millie could.
Yeah. So probably I'm imagining it's probably 5-6 feet down, or as far as they could dig anyways. I don't know how far you could dig down in this dirt. There's big boulders like that. They may have encountered a boulder or something there.
Yeah.
Hey, can you tell us anything about it, Marguerite?
No.
No?
I don't know anything.
So, well, Aline, how much do you know about the child that was here? Anything at all that you can recall?
All I know is that my dad had told me that it was an infant girl. And that's all I know. And that it was a Keener child. And I just kind of surmised over the years that it would have been a sister of Bill's, because it would have put her in about the same age bracket.
So you're talking about Bill Sr.? Is there a Bill Jr.?
I don't think so.
How long did he pass away? How long ago?
Well, I think he was in his 80s. He and my dad had a contest going between them, which one was going to last longer. Mm-hmm. My dad lasted till he was 101, but
oh,
Bill,
my.
Bill, I think he was in his late 80s when he died.
He was in his 80s. So that would have been, obviously, if he was born in 1870s.
He wasn't that old. You know, I'd say maybe 1879, right? He couldn't have been more than 3 years older than my dad.
Okay, so that would put it around about 1960.
Yeah.
Somewhere around there that he passed away. And your dad went on to live for 101.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay, well, what we're going to do now is I'm going to hopefully dig up. I think I should place that right there. I mean, I'm assuming that the body's laying this way.
Well, that makes
sense.
I mean,
the face of the rock would be over here, right? I'm thinking. Over there, Penny. So. Yeah. I'm going to assume that it's processed like that. That's a good assumption, would you say?
I would say.
Yep. Face of the rock. That way. So, let's see if I got. Can dig a hole here. Hopefully, I don't dig up something. I don't want to dig up. Right. Oops. What have we done?
Yeah, I was just thinking it could have been put at the head of the grave instead of the foot of the grave.
Already it's amazing you haven't run into rocks.
Yeah, it would have been nice if it had been raining in a couple of weeks. Just almost like it did. Probably what they did is they dug a lot of that dirt down in here and filled up a hole. This isn't helping. Could you hold that for me? You can take a picture if you want.
I'm not very good at pictures.
I wish your mom was up here.
I know.
You want to do it?
Sure.
We'll do it one time.
Yeah.
Take your camera and show her through on TV.
That's gonna be too hard.
Well, yeah, I can do it.
I need about a foot there.
Yep.
No.
Okay.
Point it down this way. There you go.
Hang on. And don't look up.
I think that ought to do it, Brian.
Yeah?
Yeah, I got one in the back and one in the front here. That should do it. Does that look straight?
Looks like it.
Okay.
Oh, here comes...
You got some rocks?
Yeah.
Let me pack this dirt. I want to throw the rocks in. And that's probably should do it. Well, that's kind of a big...
Beautiful.
Big marker, isn't it?
It's beautiful.
It's a big marker.
Let me see.
That's great. 1870s.
Yeah.
Did you just look up once? Thank you.
She's just hard to work. Yeah, that's neat.
That's great. So I put her date on the top here. Today's date says 12/5/2012. So people know that we put this here. 2012.
Oh, that's good. That's pretty secure.
Yeah, I don't think it's gonna go anywhere. Unless a mountain lion comes along and starts scratching on it. Okay.
Flowers.
Flowers? Forget the flowers.
Oh, hey, that's pretty good.
Yeah. This is for the infant Keener girl who died here in the 1870s. We were told by Helene Head here the approximate location where it was. And so we have family members here today. We have Marguerite and her mom's down there. She couldn't make it up. It's just too steep. But we thought it would be honorable to put a marker and bring family members up here. That's why we're here. And of course, this nice gentleman that helped us come up here. So there it is. Infant baby Keener's gravesite.
Well, baby, thank you for having the fortitude to continue your search for it too.
Thank you. It was a pleasure.
You're welcome.
I like my job. Okay, I'd like to get a picture of everybody standing here.
Yeah, why don't I take a picture?
Okay, good idea.